Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Now, yesterday, I showed you how to take this column of links over here in column A and basically take the link, the URL, out of each item and bring it over here to column B, doing a couple of lines of VBA. Today, we have something a little bit more complicated, but basically, I want to take the contents of all of those web pages and bring them into Excel. So, the first thing I want to do is copy those characters from the formula bar. I don't want to copy the whole cell. I want to copy just the characters. And I'm going to go to a brand new workbook. We'll turn on the macro recorder. I'll leave those settings the way they are and build the first web query. Data, import external data, new web query. In the address bar, I'm going to paste in the first page that I want to grab data from and click go. Now I'm going to wait for this to load. Now, this happens to be a page where I don't, unfortunately, have a table right around the article. So I'm going to have to grab the entire web page. But in your situation, especially if the web page is generated by some sort of a database application, there's probably a table that gets exactly what you need. Click import and then click OK for the next dialog that comes up. And you'll see that it does, in fact, pull in all the text from the web page. Well, I'm going to stop the macro recorder and go take a look at that recorded code. It's macro 5. We'll edit that. And it, as you look through this, you can kind of see where it puts the URL in here. If you ask for a specific table, it's going to ask for that table. I'm going to copy this recorded code, Control-C to copy, and go back to my workbook where I built just a few lines of an initial loop. It basically says, hey, we're going to look at everything in range B1 through, it's actually B10, and for each cell, we're going to add a new worksheet, and then I'm going to build a variable called this URL. It's equal to URL, semicolon, and the link that's in the cell. So right here in the middle of this code, I'm going to paste the recorded code. And the one thing I have to change is the recorded code has hard-coded the URL. Instead of that, I'm going to take out the hard-coded value and put the variable called this URL. Everything else is going to stay exactly the same. And we should be able to go back to Excel now. I'll close my temporary workbook. That's where I recorded the code. I don't need to save those changes. I'm back in my original code. We're going to go everywhere from B1 to B10. I'll run that code, run loop through, click run, and very quickly I'm going to get the 10 new worksheets inserted. And if we wait, sure enough, in each worksheet, I'm going to get the web page copied in. So, very quick way to go through and grab data from a website and get all that data right here on your computer. Now, my favorite example of this, is an article I wrote a couple of years ago. It's out at the website, MrExcel.com, tip 072.shtml. This is where I basically had a website where I was trying to get about 4,000 addresses from 4,000 different web pages. And this web page goes through and tells the story of exactly how I built those queries to go pull all of that data. So, while today's netcast is a very simple example, we just grabbed 10 web pages, the website has a specific example where we're able to get a whole lot of data out of a website very easily and very quickly. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.